Hi, I want to welcome everybody to our Take the Trip with Us podcast. But today we're doing this a little bit differently. I'm going to be showing a PowerPoint. This will be posted on our YouTube channel. And of course, also on our podcast, you'll just miss the visuals. But I wanted to invite everybody here today to hear about what it's like to sail on Disney Cruise Line right now, because for me and my family, it's just super exciting and we just love it. And now that we're all back at sea, you know, for us, it's the best and perfect vacation to take. But a lot of people are asking though, you know, is it right for me? Is now the time to go? Because there are changes due to the pandemic. And so I just wanted to be able to answer some of those questions, talk to some of those points for people to really understand and make that decision yourself if it's really the right thing for you. So welcome to all our listeners today and everybody that gets to hear this recording. And I'm going to share my information with you. So I'm going to start here by sharing my screen and pull up the PowerPoint here. So Disney Cruise Line back to the sea. So they started sailing back in August and my family was so excited to get back on a Disney cruise that I literally booked that cruise in like 2 weeks, you know, out. I was like, we got to get back there. So I went on the August 20th sailing of the Disney Dream. And then I went back again, August 30th, back again, September 25th on the Fantasy. And then we'll be back again on the Disney Dream coming up here in mid-October. Because for us right now, like I said, it's really an awesome opportunity to get back on the water and to see, even though there's a few changes, be able to take that vacation together as a family. So the two important steps that need to happen before you sail are the Safe Passage website and the Disney Cruise online check-in. Not only is Disney sending you these emails and telling you about it, your Wish Upon a Star With Us agent will be doing that too and letting you know, because this is very, very important as we move closer and closer to your sailing, because the Safe Passage website, it's actually run by a health company that goes and makes sure that all of the health information and vaccines and testing is all put into place before someone boards. Now, I'll go over the requirements here in just a minute, but everybody that sails does make a Safe Passage account. Now, children can be under your own account, but it starts with this pre-sale screening. And so they're going to ask you a few questions. You're going to upload your vaccination card. And right now, like I said, I'll talk about that. But right now for everybody 12 and up, for the Bahamian sailings and the sailings that are happening right now on the ships, you do have to be vaccinated. And that's not necessarily Disney's rule, but they're having to follow the rules of the ports of call that they go to. And also because they have their private island, Castaway Key, there in the Bahamas, the Bahamian government is making that a requirement. So anyone that is 12 and up does need to be vaccinated, and you will upload your vaccination card here to this website. And then it will actually show, it'll turn green and show that you're cleared to arrive to the port. If you have children that are 11 and under or between 2 and 11, they will need to have a negative COVID test. And that has to be done actually now within 72 hours. Very easy though. There are some places that, you know, maybe the test is not going to come back in time. So make sure you check. A lot of times they're free and there are some places popping up around the US that offer travel testing. So basically places you can go where you can get that result back in like 30 minutes. Make sure though that you read the directions carefully, and it's all on this Safe Passage website, of what type of test to get, because it does need to be a PCR test. It can't just be you know, a rapid test that's bought at the store. Then the embarkation information and of course disembarkation screening, this stuff will be filled out too as the time gets closer and they approve you to sail. Very easy process though. And then the Disney Cruise online check-in is also done 30 days out. And so that's when you're uploading your picture and your passport. And you know, there's been some changes due to the pandemic, but from what we're seeing, some of these changes were going to happen anyways, we were told, especially the cruise online check-in. Disney's gotten on board with a lot of this, you know, app stuff and being able to upload things ahead of time. It really saves time at the port. So I'm all for it. I've really enjoyed it. It's made things a lot easier for us. And oh, in the Safe Passage website, you can get your account, but you won't be able to upload things until about 14 days ahead of time. And so 2 weeks out, you can upload your stuff. And usually within about 24 to 48 hours, they're already sending you the approval. Then the Disney Cruise Line Navigator app, definitely go ahead. If you can download it at home, you'll be on your Wi-Fi. You can also do it at the port terminal. You'll link your reservation number in. There's so much on this app. And I know a lot of people will say, well, I don't want to mess with my phone when I'm on vacation. But if you're like me, you've got your phone anyways, because you're taking pictures and stuff. And it was so easy. My husband didn't carry his because I was the picture taker, but you know, it was so easy to just pull it up and see what the menus were for dinner. You can scan a QR code that way. I could see my account at all times. Anytime I ordered a drink or, you know, maybe bought merchandise in the store, it would come up on the app and it would show me, which was really handy. And I really liked that. So a really good tool to use while you're on board. So the morning of the cruise, you're going to attach your luggage tag right to your suitcase. I don't do it beforehand because if I'm flying in the night before, I don't want it to accidentally be taken or something. So thinking that it's going directly to the cruise line. So we just put them on the next morning. I need to go back here a second. Sorry about that. So that morning of your cruise, you will also get an email to complete a health form, and you'll find it right in the app. It's a health questionnaire. Very, very simple. There's about 5 questions, and it's just asking, you know, if you have symptoms of COVID, if you've taken care of anybody with any symptoms of COVID, some very simple questions that they want to know ahead of time for the screening. And then you'll want to keep all your documentation with you, your birth certificates, if you're using that, passports, vaccine cards, any, you know, your QR codes, and I'll show you what those look like here in the next screen. So when you arrive, you've got this QR code that's given from the Safe Pass people. And you can see that we're scanning our boarding pass here. We're scanning our health form there. Just a printout that you do before you arrive. Very easy. You can also do it on your phone. The video likes to go forward there. Sorry. So when you do that, they will let you know where to go. And everybody right now, even children that have had a negative COVID test within 72 hours will still go into the area to do a self-administered rapid test now. So if you're arriving by a shuttle, if you're arriving by, you know, bus, maybe the Disney transfer bus, you're going to go into large tents. And in those tents, they're going to give you the swab to do it. They're going to sit with someone. The nurse is going to be there. They're going to watch you swab, and then they're going to put it into the vial. And then it's usually around 30 minutes to an hour. You'll get the test results back, and then your Safe Passage will send you an email, and then you're safe to go. You still use this same code. If you're coming in by car, though, that is a little bit different. When you come in by car, you'll park. They will also scan this code, tell you where to go park, and you'll just do the test in the car. It was really easy for us. I will say we travel, or at least the past couple of cruises, it's been my husband and I and our adult son with Down syndrome. So he gets really excited about getting there to the ship and, you know, getting on board. So this time we did have to wait because we had to do the test, but we had explained to him. So it was easy though. I mean, we pulled up. They handed us the swabs. I did his for him. Super easy. He didn't mind. And then they show you where to park. You park and you wait for that email to come through. So we were able to stay in our car, which actually I really liked. Again, he got a little antsy, but we let him know, hey, you know, about 45 minutes, we got the email, we were cleared to go. And then from then it was smooth sailing because we just walked right on in. They had already taken our luggage. So they'll do that when you pull up to the port, whether either by shuttle or bus or car. And so they've already got the luggage. Really nice, because then all we had to do was go, you know, right into the terminal. When we get into the terminal and you enter, you're going to stand there and show your passport or your birth certificate and picture ID, if that's what you're using. We do really recommend passports because most people don't realize, even for kids, if you're in the Bahamas or, you know, anywhere that you would have to fly home, you cannot fly home without a passport. You must have a passport. So we use them just, you know, for that chance that something could happen and we will have to fly home. And then you're going to enter through security. And then you're going to go right up those fun stairs. And when you get up those stairs, you are right there in that terminal. And the terminal is very similar to, you know, what it looked like obviously before, but they have made some changes. You don't have to go over here where all of the line was to have to wait to check in anymore. You've already checked in downstairs and just shown your passport and they've scanned it. So as you can see, the terminal is very open. There are some seating that you can go utilize if you're having to wait a little bit for your boarding group, but pretty much after you've waited for your test and you get inside, you're going to board within probably about 15 minutes. So it's very, very quick. This is the requirement right now. So for the sailings that are going out until November the 1st, unless we hear that that's, you know, going to be extended, the Bahamas is requiring all cruise ship passengers ages 12 and up to be fully vaccinated. So again, I just encourage people to watch their email, you know, stay abreast on what's happening because this stuff is changing. There are other cruise lines and other ships that have different rules depending on what ports of call they're at. But for right now, this is what's happening with Disney. And now boarding. So boarding is still the same excitement. They're going to, they're going to talk, you know, show you your name's going to be called out. You're going to, you know, board the ship. But the key here that's a little bit different is you're going to get a welcome show when you board. And so they're going to have you stand on this family bubble. Mickey and Minnie are going to be there greeting you. So all that has been added and new and changed. And I loved it. My son loved it, but all the adults were loving it. I mean, Mickey and Minnie are there waving at you. And there's about a dozen families in the big atrium that are being welcomed at that time. And then after you do that, you're going straight to your safety briefing. And if you've sailed before and you remember how they used to do the briefing, you had to go at like 4:45 and you would all, you know, go to the safety station where you would board your lifeboat if that was the case, so that everybody gets familiar with it. Well, now you don't have to do that anymore because they're not putting people, you know, in all together into a close space. And so we just walked up to where our spot would be. You can either scan the code there on your phone on the app, or you just talk to the safety person. You know, here you can see he was there in the background. We just walked up to him and he just took our names and everything and said, you know, I'll mark you down. You've done the check-in for the safety briefing. And it was that easy. And then we could go along our way. So again, they have really thought ahead on this stuff. You know, everybody is being socially distanced or physically distanced. Yes, you do have to wear a facial covering when you're inside. But once we were out on deck, you know, he does have his on. We were not required to wear a facial covering out there on deck whatsoever. And then noticeable safety measures that I saw that were a little different than what was in the past. Obviously, there's a lot of signage around and don't know why it keeps going forward there. Sorry. We picked up our keys right there at our stateroom. So we were able to get them right there. You know, just extra cleanliness procedures that they're doing in the room. They've got a new special magnet there. And then hand sanitizers everywhere. I mean, there really were everywhere you went, there were a lot of places that you could hand sanitize. And then the elevators, they did ask on the signage here that it's only one family per elevator, or if there were just two individuals riding it. And I will tell you, for us, that was fabulous. Like, I don't want to be crammed on an elevator with a bunch of people anyways. And if you remember in the past, you know, your family might get on there and another family, and then someone else is trying to scoot in. Now everybody has been super respectful of that. And so if we're riding the elevator with our family, you know, when we get off, then it's cleared, you know, for someone else to ride. And it was very easy. There was really hardly any waiting for an elevator. But again, the ships are not filled to capacity right now. I don't know at what point that will change. But for right now, when we've been sailing, they've been about 30% capacity. I know that will be going up as more people are you know, booking and sailing. But right now, that's really helping to keep some of the spacing out, you know, when you're on the ship. But truly, truly, the magic that we remember is there, from the ice cream up on deck 11 or deck 9, depending on what ship you're on, to the awesome food that they have, to, you know, just being out on deck, the sunsets, the sunrises, I'm sure this was a sunset because I don't get up for sunrise typically. And then just, you know, getting to be on the beach, getting the entertainment that we remember and that we love so much. Like, gosh, we saw Beauty and the Beast. We saw Disney's Believe. You know, just how exciting it is to see that stuff again back. And in the theaters, you know, in the past, those theaters would be just packed full of people. Now they're offering it at two different times. And so, actually four different times, because it's already offered twice a night for the different dinner seatings. And now you've got four chances to go see a show, which is really spreading people out in the theater. And guys, you know, I don't mind because I don't always want to be sitting next to someone anyway. So it's great. And then princesses, you know, characters, everybody asks about the characters and what's that like. You know, so often I hear people say, I just want to go back when things things are normal again. Well, I hate to say it, but I'm not sure in our life, you know, things are going to go back to some of the things that we do remember that are normal. And like I said, Disney Cruise Line was already thinking about some of these things to put into place before the pandemic happened, to make it's simpler to board like they're doing right now, you know, to make things so that families can enjoy stuff, you know, without lines. And I can tell you right now, for families that are wanting to visit with especially the princesses, the character interaction is incredible. I mean, I don't normally post pictures of other people here, but you can see the, I was watching from up on like deck four. Jasmine there is talking to two young children. She was talking to those children for at least the 10 minutes that I was standing up there on deck. And, you know, in the past, they would have the princesses line up. They would have a line. You might wait 30 minutes. You might come down, you know, you would come down the line. You would get your autograph. You would get your quick picture. The princess would say hi to you and you would move on. Now they're having time to talk to the princesses. They're having time to actually interact with them. On my last cruise that I was on, I watched Rapunzel come out of, she was coming out of the door near the dining room and we were actually waiting. We were just about ready to step into the dining room. And she goes running over to these two little girls that were standing right on the other side of the stairs. And she's like, you know, hello, Susie and Jamie, you know, I guess she knew their names because she had talked to them like that morning or the day before. She's like, what are you doing today? And of course, you know, they're, you know, in their full character. I mean, they're the princess. They're talking to these little girls. The little girl's eyes were just huge because here this princess had taken time to come running over to talk to them and did just like what she's doing right now, you know, bent down talking to a little girl here that you can't see in the picture. But please know that the character interaction that these kids are getting right now is by far the best I have ever, ever seen on a ship. And I really think that's because they're being allowed to just come up and talk as they want to. There's no long lines waiting for things, and they're available at many more times than they were in the past. Castaway Key Day. And of course, Castaway Key hasn't changed either. It's amazing. It's awesome. You've got the beach, the barbecue, the ocean, the water activities, the bars, you know, it's all right there. And those beaches are phenomenal. They're great. I have been floating out there in crystal clear blue water, five or six times now in the past 6 weeks, and I cannot wait to go back again here. They have done a little change here in the app where they have a virtual queue for you to, you know, get on in the morning, like 7:30, you just say that you want to join the queue to leave. However, honestly, by the time we're ready to go, our time, it's already been our group. So we've never had to wait. We just checked in the morning, said, okay, we're going to be, you know, leaving, getting off the ship in about an hour. No problem. You know, we had our breakfast, went to get off the ship and that was, you know, perfect timing. Here's just a few pictures around the island. They do still ask for, you know, physical distancing. You only have to wear a facial covering now when you're on transportation and when you're going up to get your food, when you're kind of inside the Cookies barbecue. But if you're outside and you're outside eating and you're out in the open areas, even the cast members don't have to wear a facial covering. It's their choice. Some do still, but they don't have to do that. And now they have been lightening some of the signage that is on the island. So now you can move chairs around, which they were asking people not to do before. You can move your chair down into the water. Again, they're not requiring facial coverings in the restroom right now. And also all the play areas are open. So I've been down that Pelican Point slide a couple times now, and it's very exciting, but all that's open. The climbing thing is open. So kids can go and adults can go enjoy all that stuff. So really, really cool. And then I'll try to get this to go forward here. The smiling faces. Oh my goodness. These people, these crews are so happy to have us back because they have missed us so much. You know, they spent so much time on those ships, not knowing what was going to happen, you know, being away from their home, wishing that guests could get back on board, and we're back and they are happy to have us back. I can tell you that. Youth activities. A lot of people have asked about this. Same thing. Kids have the same great spaces to go and enjoy. As you can see, though, they do have a little bit of a line here I'm showing in the video. I never saw someone in line here, but they do have people spread out if you were waiting to check your children in. Here is just a picture on the app. You do get a chance to book ahead of time. And you can book a couple time slots ahead of time. They are just 1.5 hour time slots now for children. But what they're doing is they're doing really focused activities during this time that the kids get to move through and do. So it's really cool because they get to do activities with a small group and one counselor. So they're getting a lot of interaction and of attention with that counselor. So it's really neat. And we talked to the youth counselors when we were on board, and they said, you know, there's still plenty of time to book and go, you know, like it says right here. I pulled it up on my app, you know, at 5:50 that evening, I could have booked now. And if I had a young child, they could have gone to the youth activities. Characters, fireworks, like I said, all that fun stuff is back. None of it's gone. I mean, and now it's really, for me, it's the same as what it was before. I'm getting the fireworks. Actually, I like the fireworks show better. You can actually see my son there getting some interaction with Captain Hook and Smee. And what was so funny is they were up there on the stairs for quite some time, and he saw them across the pool deck and was waving and waving and waving, and they were waving. And again, this was probably 10, 12 minutes that they spent waving at him, you know, from a distance, but he didn't care. And he's saluting them right there. He also loved seeing Captain Jack out on Castaway Key. So again, you're getting character photos, you're getting this interaction with them. It is just at a distance. It really is. And you know, people ask, well, I want my kid to be able to give Mickey a kiss on the nose again. I don't know if that's ever going to happen again. I don't know if it's ever going to happen again at Disney World. I mean, when you really think about everybody, person after person kissing Mickey's nose, you know, I just don't know if that's going to ever happen again. But as far as getting closer to the characters, I think as time goes on, I think, yes, we will be able to do that. Right now, we're still able to get pictures. As you can see, he is still very excited about that. And from what I could see on board, no child was upset, you know, having to get a picture from a distance. They were just so happy to be able to talk to those characters and interact and be with them for a length of time. A little bit more about the Navigator app now. Like I said before, everything is in this app. They make it very simple for you. There's you know, instance of where I purchased something. I could include more gratuity if I wanted to. It's showing me that I've checked out. I can do a chat with a cast member. I don't have to go to wait in a line at guest services. If I want to talk to someone, I can just do it right on the app, ask them a question. A crew member is going to come on there and talk to me. And so you can see, you know, how that works. It was really simple, really easy. I've done that, you know, in the past, like laying in bed at night. If I had a question and I like, you know what, it's 10 o'clock at night, but I'm just going to chat them real quick and see if they have, you know, the answer to this. And it works really, really well. But for our family, we feel this is such a great time to take advantage of, you know, not as many people on the ships, and, you know, pricing is great. It's a super time to be able to go and sail. And even as things move forward, I don't see anything else really changing. I mean, everything is back. The two things, I guess, that would stick out to me the most would be that I do have to wear a facial covering as I enter the ship and I walk to, you know, another area of the ship. If I'm sitting down at dinner, obviously, you know, I'm eating my dinner, I'm distanced from other people. And I'm also not, I guess the biggest thing too, is I'm not just seeing lines around, because, you know, people are having a lot more opportunity to either see characters or see a show or, you know, participate in things. And so people are being spread out while they're doing that. And so, you know, we're not having the lines all around. I think one other thing too, is I can't have popcorn right now while I watch a movie, because I can't take my facial covering off. So that if there's one thing I would say, I can't wait till that comes back, because I want to be able to watch those first run movies and those you know, big movies in the theater and be able to have popcorn. But other than that, it is a great time to be on a Disney cruise. So I'm going to open it up for questions. I believe you can unmute yourself if you want to. I will double check that and see. The one last thing I did want to say is thank you so much. You can find our podcast on iHeartRadio, Spotify, Google Podcasts, even Amazon Music. But Take the Trip with Us, we do a lot of different locations, and I talk with different agents that have visited these locations. So really great way to learn about new you know, destinations around the world that you may want to visit. So I'll open it up for questions right now if anybody has anything they want to ask me. Well, again, I thank everyone for coming today and listening to us. And don't forget to check us out on Take the Trip with Us.